Hi there, what's your name?
My name is Lorna Navarro, Bishop.
Very well. Where are you traveling from?
I travel from Meifu, Kowloon.
Good. And where are you from back home?
I am from Philippines in the province of Abra.
Very well. So when you came to the UCKG Help Center, you carried a lot of emotional problems. Give us a better idea about your story.
Yes, Bishop. Before I came to the Universal Church Help Center, I had been living a life that is far away from God. That I had been far away from God, even if I was attending a church, I've been doing that, giving this, doing that, but it was a life that was so far away from God. And starting from the person that I was, that was living far away from God, I was a very insecure person. I always compare myself with others, focusing on what others have that I don't have, and what they can do that I cannot do. That always bring me to bitterness, that always bring me to like grudges without the people knowing I'm comparing myself with. And I also was a person who was with very low self-esteem. People may see me from the outside well because I was doing that, doing this, but deep inside nobody knew that I had a very low self-esteem. I didn't believe in myself. I didn't have a way of to have decisions on myself. That sometimes when I am in a difficult situation, I will ask people, if you were in this situation where I am, what would you do? And then what they will say, I will do. I didn't have a mind of my own. I will follow what people say. And also, I was a very fearful person, that just by knowing that I would start something or I will do something very new that I am not so sure about, just the thought of doing that or trying that, voices would come already in my mind telling me that it's hard, I cannot do it, it's very complicated, people will laugh at me when they know that I don't know how to do it. So I will follow those voices, and I would just be content not trying that new thing or doing that new thing. Can I give an example, Bishop?
Sure.
Yes, just like when I came to Hong Kong, I had been carrying that fear that for other people to acquire a single journey octopus in the MTR, it was very easy for them. But Bishop, for many years in Hong Kong, I was afraid to buy or acquire a single journey octopus because just by looking at the people doing that on the machine, voice would come to my mind already that it was very difficult. It was very complicated, and people would laugh at me when they see that I don't know how to do that. And only when I was 2 years already in the church that I had the chance to do that, and then I realized that it was very easy and I enjoy doing it already.
Yeah, now, yes. Something interesting. Did you grow up going to church?
Yes, Bishop.
So you were all your life familiar with going to church?
Yes.
And the scriptures?
Yes, Bishop. I even studied and work in an institution that is like that preach about the Word of God.
A Christian environment.
Yes.
Yeah. You know, an important lesson that we learn here with Lorna is that you can have people that are in the church, and they may be in the church, but they have never experienced the power of God. People that are in the church with low self-esteem, with depression, with a lot of shortcomings. Nobody's perfect, but there is a promise that says, whoever is in Christ Jesus becomes a new creation, and the Spirit of God gives us power and confidence. So you were in a church and working in a church environment,
yes,
growing up in a church,
yes,
but you had never experienced Christ's,
yes,
power within you. You were empty of that.
Yes, Bishop. I was depressed.
Depression as,
yes,
well. give us an idea about the depression and the root of your depression.
Yes, Bishop. I knew that, I didn't know that I was depressed. I only came to know that I was depressed when I was here attending the meetings in the Universal Church. I thought it was just normal for me to act like that, to think like that. And I believe that it started the depression even when I was a child, because I was a very close person. I wanted to isolate myself. I didn't know how to express myself fully, even when there are things that I wanted to share from inside of me. I don't know who to speak with. And there were many issues in my childhood that I was not able to share with anyone. I kept them. They were bottled up inside of me. They were unresolved. And that gave me the loneliness and the sadness that I just dealt with within me. Like, I never spoke to my family or anyone about my experience when I was a child, that in separate occasions, I was molested by relatives. I didn't speak about it. I just kept them inside of me. And then that gave me like guilt. That why it happened, because of me, I was doing something wrong. That's why people did that to me. And also, there was also a very outstanding or powerful experience in my past that gave me so much guilt, Bishop, that when I was 10 or 11 years old, I was carrying my baby sister, who was like 2 years old at that moment, and then she slipped down from my arms and then fell down on the floor. And then, even though the doctors declared that there was no serious injury, but I was so guilty and I was so sad when she died when she was 3 years old, even though the cause of the death was not because she fell, but because of disease. But because I was young, nobody would taught me about what happened, and nobody advised me or comforted me. So I carried that guilt until I was adult. That when I think of that incident, it was very, very fresh, that I would even shudder, and I would feel pity to my younger sister who fell to the floor, even though I know that when she died she's already an angel. But the feeling was so strong inside of me, the guilt and the sadness.
Yeah, so we can see here that if the whole world has a problem, it doesn't necessarily mean that it's normal. And in her case, in Lorna's case, she had to understand that her problem wasn't normal. That's the first thing you have to recognize, that not everybody having similar problems, it proves that your problem is normal. It may be an abnormal problem, simply that other people haven't found a solution yet. And you found the solution. And the root of your depression came because of childhood disappointments.
Yes, Bishop.
Childhood, you know,
traumas. Yes.
That were bottled up inside of you.
Yes,
and a lot of people have to understand today that they may carry things from their childhood up until today they have never resolved. And when you came to the UCKG Help Center, you found the altar, you used your faith. Give us an idea how you used your faith and how you turned your life around.
Yes, Bishop. Before I came to the Universal Church, I would like also to mention that because of all this emptiness and the depression that I had been carrying, that I didn't know how to resolve, I wanted to speak to someone, but I didn't know where to go. And so I searched for like comfort outside my home, because I could not speak these issues with my family. I searched for comfort outside my family, until also I was in a relationship, in a very wrong relationship, that later with this relationship led me to addiction in pornography. That with this point in my life, I consider it as the darkest in my life, because I would it's like I was already in a prison. I was physically free, but in my mind I was imprisoned. There was something that is holding me that I don't know where to go. I don't know how to start my life. And I remember, Bishop, that when I was attending the church where I came from, my prayer was, I was asking God to free me, to take me out from the bondage, to take me out from the prison that I was, the invisible prison that I was. That was my prayer when I was in the church, attending before I came to the Universal Church. And God answered my prayer. He brought me to the Universal Church in one of the events here in Universal Church, the Holy Oil event. And when I came here, on the first day that I came here, I found that this place was very different, was positive. There was a happy environment. The people are happy. The people are kind. The people are helpful. And I even told myself that on the first day of my coming in the Universal Church, I said that it was like I found an oasis after a long journey in the desert. That's how tired I was. That's how tormented I was. That it's like coming to the Universal Church on that day was a relief for me.
Yeah, and there are many people out there, they are looking for a way out. There are many people searching for an answer, a sign, a way out. If you would only make that sincere prayer and you would say, Lord, show me a way, help me. I want to change the situation of my life. I don't know where to begin. I don't know how to do that alone. But where there is sincerity, God will make a way where there is no way. And we have a next event coming up called the Ask event, where people are able to ask, not friends or family, but we're going to ask the Creator. He will be able to reset your life and people can make a new beginning. How is Lorna today?
Now I can say, Bishop, that I have overcame all those issues, because here in the Universal Church, I was taught to that in order for a problem to be solved, we have to go to the root. We have to go deep, to dig deep inside of us, that many times it was painful, it was hard, that many times I also wanted to give up, wanted to stop. But the power of God, the presence of God was always pushing me to have the perseverance to continue. And now, just by the fact that I'm here speaking about myself, now I am not ashamed of myself anymore. I was so ashamed of myself before, Bishop. I don't want to see people who knew me before. I was hiding. Now, with this, I know that I have overcame. God has healed me from depression. God has healed me from the addiction. The healing that nobody, no clinic, no doctor can give. It's just God who can give the healing of depression and the addiction and all the issues that I had carried, that made me lonely, that made me depressed, and made me a very person that is not liked by people.
So, Lorna, today you're even smiling, talking about your whole story. We know, and clearly we can see that the past is gone. It no longer affects you today.
Yes, Bishop.
Now, apart from this transformation inside out, what is the biggest victory in your life?
The healing of my soul, Bishop, my salvation.
Thank you for sharing.
Ask and you will receive.
One of the most underused tools of success
is the power of asking. But few people know how to ask in the right way.
Asking intelligently is a very good way
to find the root of your problems.
Knowing how to ask
is the beginning
of getting what you want.
Universal Church of the Kingdom of God, helping you to make a new beginning.